This is the Thriving Dentist Show with Gary Takas, where we help you develop your ideal dental practice, one that provides personal, professional, and financial satisfaction.
Welcome to another edition of the Thriving Dentist Show. I'm Gary Takas, your show host. My guest on today's show is my friend, Elijah Desmond. Elijah is the founder of the program called Smiles at Sea. As the name might indicate, Smiles at Sea is all about combining serious dental continuing education with cruises. We're going to talk about some innovative concepts that Elijah is bringing to the world of dental CE, and specifically, we're going to talk about an upcoming cruise called the Smiles at Sea Cuba Cruise happening in October 2019. I'll be one of the speakers on that cruise, and Elijah's going to share with you some cool things he's got planned around that cruise and just around some innovative things he's doing in the world of dental continuing education. Before we get to that interview, though, we have another Let's Ask David segment. Of course, David is my dear friend, Dr. David Hornbrook. In this Let's Ask David segment, David's going to talk about the benefits of belonging to very specific aesthetic dentistry associations. He's going to talk about the benefits of being a member of the AACD, the American Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry, and also the ASDA, the American Society of Dental Aesthetics. David's going to share with you the benefits and the value you get by associating with like-minded dentists in quality associations. I think you'll appreciate this Let's Ask David segment. David, I know throughout your career you've been really involved in the AACD, and I'm a young dentist and considering becoming a member of the AACD. What are your thoughts?
Well, I'm going to expand from just the AACD. And for those that say, what the heck is that? It's the American Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry. And it really should be called the International Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry because it represents, I think, over 45 countries. And it's a tremendous organization. In fact, this coming April, the annual meeting is in San Diego. I'm very excited about that. So the AACD, I would say, is absolutely an unbelievable organization. But I'm going to add one to that, and that's the ASDA, the American Society of Dental Aesthetics. A little smaller group, a little tighter knit, still excellent lectures, excellent yearly meeting. It's always in October, so it's great to go to the AACD in April or May and the ASDA, American Society of Dental Aesthetics, in October. What those meetings are all about is improving the quality of care and number of services that you can provide your patient. Excellent lectures, excellent mentors, trying to help you become a better dentist. Now, part of this whole process, potentially, part of this whole process is to become accredited. Accredited or a fellow in the AACD, or a fellow or even a diplomat in the ASDA, where by having your peers evaluate your dentistry, it gives you a better appreciation to what you're doing and really how good you can be. I always tell people that, you know, you could do the very best case. You think it's unbelievable, and then you blow it up in a slide and you realize, you know, there's an open gingival embrasure, or there's a little bit of recession around a veneer that's on one of them but not on the other. And you think, you know what? That case would have been that much better if I would have taken a little bit more time, whether it being adding an additional tooth, making the gingival levels, whatever it is. And so part of that whole process of being a member, in my opinion, of either one of those organizations is trying to up your game by becoming either accredited or a fellow or a diplomat in the ASDA. But it's really a networking of like-minded people. You know, you don't go to this meeting and people aren't taking CPR classes, quite frankly. You know, they could care less because they're going to get that through their dental society. You know, they're not taking sterilization or OSHA courses. They're there whether they want to do more with lasers, with gingival recontouring. They want to be better smile designers. They want to know what the leading ceramics are. They want to rub shoulders or network with like-minded ceramists, or likewise, the ceramist like-minded dentist. So both groups are excellent. If I was a young dentist, and you know, I mentor, this year it's 50 young dentists, 5 years or under. The first thing I do is join some organizations, and they raise their hand and say, which ones are those? And I say, well, I've got two for you, AACD and the ASDA. So no, that was kind of a long answer to that. I think it'd be a mistake for someone that wants to You know, do more cosmetic dentistry, be better at it, have more self-confidence in aesthetic dentistry or restorative dentistry, is to join both of those groups.
Awesome. Well, I mentioned in the intro that my guest on today's Thriving Dentist Show is my friend, Elijah Desmond. Hey, Elijah, how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you doing, Gary?
Man, it's great to hear your voice. Of course, you and I got to spend some significant time together this year. And
yes.
When I roll the highlight reel of 2018, you are featured prominently in my highlight reel.
That's awesome. I'd like to see this highlight reel. Is this in your head or is it a video, actual video?
It's actually in my head.
Oh, cool. I can see it.
It's a virtual video in my head. But hey, to let our listeners in on this, I was a featured speaker at a Smiles at Sea program. In fact, the very first Smiles at Sea Alaska cruise.
Yes.
Wasn't that amazing?
Oh, man, it was such a good time. And thank you for that, by the way. You did such an amazing job at that and brought so much value to all of our attendees. It was amazing in Alaska.
Well, and I look at every component of that, you know, certainly a cruise to Alaska from a scenic standpoint and just the amount of territory that we covered and we got to see. What an amazing experience. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes, I totally agree. We'll probably do that in another 3 to 5 years, I would say.
Well, and then secondly, I think of three big elements of that trip. One was the cruise. Another was just the quality of the continuing education.
Yeah, we had a great lineup. Huh? I'm bringing most of you back next October.
So we're going to talk about that. And then third was the networking and the learning that happened outside of the formal CE time.
Yes, that was amazing.
You know, at meals and in the bowling alley on the ship. You know, on Roy's you know, Roy had a balcony in his stateroom, and we could look out at the glacier. You know. The networking that went on in the balcony. I mean, cool stuff.
Yes, it was. You know what? I can honestly say that I've had some really good speakers come through my events. That was hands down my best speaker lineup that I've had to date to Alaska. And here's the thing. You know, we wanted to have, my events are typically for dentists and their teams, right? They set this goal and they take their team on this trip. Well, that was more a dentist or a dental professional and their spouse. So it's a different vibe. So listen, I don't know if you're going to be you're going to be in for a shock for this one that we have in October.
Well, hey, let's inform our audience about what's coming up in October of 2019. And Elijah, would you, we get new listeners all the time. We currently have listeners in 172 countries, which I find to be just such a blessing to have such a wonderful international audience. Would you be kind enough to share a little bit about your background and also what sort of motivated you to found Smiles at Sea?
Absolutely. So, you know, I was raised in the United States in Ohio, and was raised on a big farm. And I decided I didn't want to do that farm work for a living for my whole life. It was a little bit too sweaty for me, and I didn't like carrying big bales of hay. I don't know if any of the listeners have been on a farm before or worked on one. You know what I'm saying. So I wanted to go into a different field that allowed me to be in the AC. And so I decided that I would go to be a dental hygienist. And 15 years old, I ended up testing out of high school, and I began my career as a motivational speaker. 6 years later, graduated from The Ohio State University and moved straight to Honolulu, Hawaii, where you just were just in Hawaii a couple of days ago.
I just returned from that fine state.
And so I started as a hygienist after I graduated. However, I am a serial entrepreneur. Actually, my book just came out serial entrepreneur from startup to success. And I started my first business after being in a dental practice for, you know, about 2 months. I just couldn't understand how in the world I was making this dentist $2,000 to $3,000 per day, and I was only bringing home about $400 per day. Something just didn't make sense to me there. So I said, you know what, I'm going to start my own business. And I started a dental temp agency. Fast forward, that was 2009 when I graduated and started that. I've started now 11 businesses, one of them being Smiles at Sea. And my focus now is a lot of giving back and teaching people, even in our own industry, that they have a beautiful mind and that they're capable of anything. And then also making my speaking career very focused around kids and teaching kids that they're capable of anything. And really just storytelling, teaching them about the stories that I went through on my journey to get where I'm at, you know, today. And, you know, it's been a good ride in dentistry so far. You know, spoke for Invisalign in over 50 cities, spoke for Straumann in over 50 cities. And now I've been independent and working my way back into the high schools and not speaking as much in dentistry. But, man, I sure do love hosting dental speakers that are better than me, like yourself, Gary, on the show.
Well, we sure had a good time in Alaska. And, you know, what I love about your Smiles at Sea events is that they're really all about being surrounded by people who are totally passionate about our profession.
Yes.
You know, literally one of the nights on the cruise to Alaska, we were together with a group of the attendees at the bowling alley, you know, on the ship. And I think we're bowling, I don't know, I think we started about 9 o'clock and, you know, here it is 11 o'clock, 11:30, midnight. And everyone's just talking about dentistry.
Yeah.
And how we can better the experience of our patients. And
yeah.
what a great experience. So, if you would, Elijah, tell our listeners about your October 2019 event.
Absolutely. Well, you know, I'm going to go ahead and start from the cruise and I'm going to work backwards because we have the actual cruise. It's October the 19th through the 23rd, which we have the honor of hearing you and another nice lineup of speakers. I'd like to list them if you give me the chance. But we basically in October, we actually have a few different tracks. So there's the general track, the general session. But then we also have breakout sessions as well. So there's a general track. And in that general track speaking, we have you, Gary, we have Carrie Weber, we have Dr. Roy Shelburne, we have Dr. Ross Nash, we have Deborah Nash. Thanks to you, we have Fred Joyle, which has been on the list for a while. Mm-hmm. Excited to hear him. And then we have Laura Hatch, we have Dr. Anessa Holmes, and we have Sue Jeffries. And then we also have Dr. Paul Homily. So that's in the general session, you know, a total of 12 hours of CE. And then we have two breakout sessions. We have a session for some of your teams. We have a front office rocks cruise going on in one of the breakout rooms. In the other breakout room, we have a dental implant track going on that's powered by my other company, Driven Dental Implant Marketing. Mm-hmm. And it's, you know, we have some of the classes, we actually all come together in the theater to learn together. And it's extremely laid back. You know, there's 12 CEs. We're going to Cuba, by the way. Did I mention that, Gary? We're going from Fort. You happen to get with me on all of the really good events, right? So we're going to Cuba and Key West from Fort Lauderdale the 19th through the 23rd. So block your calendars early. That's going to be the cruise itself. And I'll tell you what, the best things that happen, in my opinion, are not even necessarily the speakers during the educational parts. It's just like you said, it's afterwards. You go to a normal conference and everybody disperses. When you go to a cruise, you're stuck. So you're the magic happens after the cruise classes are over. And now you're getting to network with all of the speakers. You're getting to, you know, somebody would love to meet you, Gary, you know, especially international. now it's a time where you can hang out with Gary for 4 days in the ship, you know, hang out with Fred Joyle, hang out with Ross Deborah Nash. And anyways, it's just it's a big relationship piece. And there's a majority of our people bring their team. So it's dentists and their team. So in a nutshell, that is what the 19th through the 23rd is all about. And the things that happened before the cruise, oh man, that's interesting. So what do you want to talk about first? Do you want to talk about Dentistry's Got Talent or this Mastermind?
Let's talk about Dentistry's Got Talent next. And then we'll get to the Mastermind.
Okay. Absolutely. So, you know, before I give you the overview, do you have any specific questions you have for me? Or should I just give you the overview of what's going
to
happen?
Well, I want to sort of provide an introduction, if I may, to that, Elijah. And that is that I love the innovation that you are bringing to dental education. It's needed.
Yes.
And, you know, technology is part of the core of this, because our technology allows us to do things today that we couldn't do, you know, even a year ago, or even 2 years ago. But you're also bringing together a culture, and it's a culture of people that are passionate about our profession. And you're also creating a forum for new voices in dentistry.
Yes.
And I love it. It's very interesting to me, because I think you walk a fine line, Elijah, and I'm very fond of the way you do this, because you honor and respect the history and tradition of dentistry, but you also create a platform or a forum for new voices to contribute as well.
Yes.
I mean, and I'm not going to throw anyone under the bus or any meetings under the bus, but if you look at some of the traditional dental conferences, it's the same speakers who have been giving the same presentation for many, many, many years.
Yes.
And I think it's important to have respect for the trailblazers and for those that have, you know, earned that spot. But we also have to create a platform and a forum for new talent.
Yes. Yeah. I 1000% agree. So I'll tell you how it got started. Well, first off, the big picture is it's called Dentistry's Got Talent. And Dentistry's Got Talent is essentially, it is a way to learn differently. So typically you go to a conference to learn, or you go to a study club to learn. With Dentistry's Got Talent, you look on your phone on Facebook Live and you get live continuing education from some of the best speakers in dentistry or up-and-coming speakers in dentistry. And these speakers, they speak on in a TED Talk style. So that means that we have 50 speakers, and each speaker is speaking for approximately 10 minutes. So what will happen is that we'll get all the speaker abstracts, and we'll say, okay, you know, we have a total of 5 speakers that are speaking on dental implants or clinical dentistry. We'll put all the clinical speakers in 1 hour. They'll speak 10 minutes apiece. We have another one that say there's 5 more that speak on oral cancer. So we'll put 5 oral cancer speakers in the exact same hour. So they get a CE for oral cancer. Then we have practice management speakers. Say we have 10 of those. And then there's an hour on that. And the cool part is most of the time you go to these conferences or you hear a speaker speak, and let's go ahead and face it. We put some fluff in there. There's some things that we don't necessarily have to have in our presentation, but you got to fill that 2-hour slot. So you got to put it in there with something. It's relevant fluff, but let's all admit it. We've all been guilty of giving some fluff before. Sure. I've given it before. You've given it before. I'm sure everybody has. So 10 minutes, you got to come guns blazing, right? And so
it's an abbreviated TED Talk format.
Yes.
You know, the TED Talk format is typically 17 minutes. So this is roughly half of a TED Talk format. So as a speaker, you've got to have your best stuff for 10 minutes.
Yes, exactly. And here's what makes it even better. These speakers that are speaking, they're trying to give you the best content they can give, because you know what? They want to make it to the finals. And so you, as a Facebook viewer, you will actually be able to vote 2 people into the finals. It gets even better. It's kind of like American Idol in a way, because we have judges on the stage, And these judges that are on the stage are, you know, our honorary judge this year is actually Linda Miles. We have a couple of others as well. But what happens is they are judging the entire event, and they turn their scorecards in, and we find out from them the top two that they put in the finals, the judges. So together you have four people that are speaking that in the finals for 5 minutes each, and they all get on stage again and give another 5 minute presentation. The winner gets a contract to speak on the Smiles at Sea cruise to Bermuda in 2020. Here's, it gets even better. The winner of that event will face in a final round all of the winners from Dentistry's Got Talent since we started. So the winner of that event and five other winners will speak again for 10 minutes each to see who will win the overall grand prize of $3,000. And I'm also going to make something really cool. It's actually a big tournament of champions, like heavyweight championship belt with a microphone on it.
Very cool.
So what's the why behind that, Gary? What's the reasoning for making this? It wasn't really to be just like to create a cool event. It was because each year I had over 100 speakers that were applying to speak on my cruise ship. And as a speaker, I hate to be told, no, you can't speak. We're full. We're booked out until 2025. Come on. I don't like to hear that. And as a speaker, you don't like to hear it. So I say, you know what? I'm going to make an opportunity where we can bring on 50 speakers. And if they win, then they speak on the cruise. That's how they speak. So we're actually right now in the process of looking for our speakers for Dentistry's Got Talent. So regardless of what you speak on, we would love to have you apply to be a speaker. And so I was tired of telling people we're full. So that's why I created Dentistry's Got Talent. All these people said, hey, we'll be able to, I'm a great speaker. I can speak on this or that. And I'll bring a large audience. And I said, okay, that sounds good. Win Dentistry's Got Talent, and then you can speak on the ship. Right. And so, but Gary, you passed that up, right? You didn't even have to speak at Dentistry's Got Talent. You got the back door, smart guy. Right. So anyways, you know, here's another thing. It's not just about the new speakers. It's about a new technology, and it's about people that want to reach what the amount of people that they wouldn't be able to reach for 10 years. In just a 48-hour period, you know, we have already hit 50,000 views. That's a lot of views, Gary. 50,000. So think about it. As a speaker, I don't care if you've spoken one time or for 10 years, how many years would it take you typically to get in front of that many people? I would say that would be many years, probably more than 10, to get in front of that many people, that many people view it. So it's an opportunity for speakers that are already polished to stay in the front space in front of these thousands of people and to stay relevant. Also, I have meeting planners from across the country that are watching this live feed and they're seeking talent. You know, a lot of times the meeting planners don't want to wait they don't want to wait through 2 hours and fly across the country to go see to scout. Now they can scout from the palm of their hand, right? And then we have companies that are looking to scout for speakers to sponsor. They're looking for speakers to sponsor for their products or services that match their message.
You know, just to be clear with our listeners, I know you cover this, but I want to make sure they understand. The Dentistry's Got Talent event will be happening live in Florida right before the Smiles at Sea Cuba cruise. However, the viewers can literally be anywhere in the world because this is going to be broadcast live on Facebook Live. Is that correct?
That is correct. And thank you for bringing that up. It is not the same thing as the ship. It's 2 days before. Thursday and Friday, October the 17th and October the 18th. And it is not on the ship. It's actually in Fort Lauderdale.
One of the reason I wanted to have you on this podcast, besides just your passion and your commitment to making dentistry better, I wanted our listeners to have an opportunity to participate in this because we have listeners in 172 countries. Wow. So literally any of our listeners can tune into this on Facebook Live free, correct?
Yes, free. And the CE is free as well. Yep.
Now, there's a wrinkle that goes along with this. In addition to the competition, you're going to have some veteran speakers participating in this as well, correct?
Absolutely. I'm going to have the veteran speakers participating, and I'm also going to have the speaking coaches in our industry speaking as well. So all of those people that I listed off that are going to be speaking on the ship, they're going to get on stage for 5 minutes and give you a 5-minute talk about whatever they decide they want to talk about. But they're going to speak as well. In Dentistry's Got Talent. But the thing is you can't vote on them, right? We took the fun right out of it, but at least you get to hear them.
Right.
So we're looking forward to having them involved. However, you know, it gets a step further to kick off this event. Both days, what we're doing is we are having the speaking coaches. Okay. The speaking coaches that essentially teach these speakers to be powerful. And they have like the speaker and consulting, you know, groups or organizations. We're having them come on and set the tone for this entire event. So the organizations that are the speakers that we're going to have, we will have the Speaker Consultant Network with Lois Banta. Mm-hmm. We'll have Catherine Itell Belt with Lion Speak. We'll have Claudia with Murado, Allied Speaker and Consultant. Mm-hmm. We will have Mark LeBlanc representing the National Speakers Association. We will have Carrie representing ADMC. We'll have Shirley Gakowski representing Dental Speaker Institute. We'll have Vanessa Emerson representing Dental Speaker Institute.
Right.
And we'll have Sherry Gakowski representing Talent Accelerator. And then lastly, we'll have Homily Communications representing Dr. Paul Homily will be representing Homily Communications.
So literally you're bringing together all of the different organizations that provide the training and proving ground for speakers and consultants.
Yes, we are. And to make it even a next level, make it even cooler, what we're doing is we are having a meeting before Dentistry's Got Talent that is closed to the public, unfortunately. However, we're having a meeting with all of those organizations called Masterminds, the Meeting for the Future. And what we've done is we look at those organizations as essentially influencers of the influencers of dentistry. We're putting them all in one room together, and we're going to bring in some other large organizations. So one of the large organizations that we're bringing in is Front Office Rocks, you know, with Laura Hatch. We're also bringing in Dental Profit Academy with Dr. Anessa Holmes. We're bringing in Dental Success Network, DSN, with Mark Costas. He'll be representing DSN. And then we're bringing in Lee Duke with Dental Peeps Network. We're bringing in Swipe with Ekram, and I believe we don't have confirmation yet if Dr. Tony Stefano is coming or not, but Ekram has. Then we're also bringing in SmileSource. They have over 1,000 dentists in their network with SmileSource. And actually, Trevor Maurer is going to be another one of our guest judges with SmileSource. So, man, it is going to be an amazing event. But here's the thing. All of this is being powered by Smiles at Sea and Dental Hub 360. And so, you know, we're putting on this event and our overall goal, because it is a closed event, this event that's happening before the live video, it's not even open to the public. It's just the owners of these associations. And what's going on is we are essentially taking all of these organizations and talking about how do we move the industry together instead of separately? Because let's be honest, Gary, you know, many of these organizations, they work independently. There's not a sense of unity with everyone. Right. And I'm on this mission along with, you know, Dr. Anessa Holmes, Dr. Glenn Vaux, Dr. Chris Hoffpower with Dental Hub 360, to actually unite our industry and move it forward. So what we're doing is we're going to bring in somebody that's not in dentistry. And what they do is they're a professional facilitator. So they're going to facilitate this 4-hour meeting that we're going to have before Dentistry's Got Talent. And essentially, each one of these organizations is going to submit two things that they want to discuss. And it will be a complete open forum at the table on how do we bring the industry together and move it forward. So they're going to submit two questions or two topics. We're all going to discuss it. And after that, we're going to enjoy Dentistry's Got Talent for 2 days straight through for the Facebook Live. And then it's all going to – the Dentistry's Got Talent is going to conclude with a black tie event where all of the – all of these organizations and all 50 speakers, all the speakers in the ship are going to come together to do a black tie event in a ballroom. And we're going to sell a limited amount of tickets for that so that everybody gets to network and mingle before the next day when we get on the ship and head to Cuba.
You know, I like I said, I wanted to have you on the podcast so we could let our listeners know about these upcoming events. And so there's a number of ways, if I could, before we talk about Dental Hub 360, as a listener, there's a number of ways that you can participate with this. One, you can come join us on this Cuba cruise. I will be there. I'll be there the entire time. The lineup of speakers, as Elijah has mentioned, is literally world class. You'll have an opportunity to hang out with us for 4 days, and I would invite you to come join us. Elijah, if our listeners are interested in registering for the cruise, where's the best place for them to go to do that?
Absolutely. It's on the website. It's smilesatsea.com. Is the website for the cruise, and they can find out all the information and details right on smilesatsea.com. And then they can actually, we're actually came out with a new booking system. It's kind of like StubHub, where they can get all their questions answered and they can book right there and pick their cabin even. They can pick their cabin number right from the website.
You know, one of the things that I'm impressed with that you've been able to do with these Smiles at Sea programs is because of the volume of attendees, you've been able to secure some very attractive pricing. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're able to get discounts on cruises because we have the, you know, we have a massive amount of people. We're putting over 600 people on this ship here in a couple of months. Well, I say about, it's only 50 days away. So we're able to get good pricing. So essentially what you'll pay for is the cruise itself. The rooms start around $560. And then the event itself for dentists is it starts at $697 and for team members, $335. And that's with the earliest bird pricing. And it goes on up to maxing out at $1,000. But if you book right away, right, February, the second week of February, the tickets go live, you'll actually be able to save a lot of money. Very affordable for a dentist and their team members to go on the cruise and get that continuing education. But more importantly, build a relationship with all of these industry leaders those 4 days.
You know, it is an incredible value when you just look at the tuition broken down by the number of CE units. It's an incredible value.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So there's another way, obviously other ways that our listeners can participate, that if it's not possible for you to attend the Cuba cruise, I would strongly encourage you to do that. But if that's not possible, you can participate by viewing the Dentistry's Got Talent event that's going to be happening on the 17th and 18th of October. And that's free. And that's going to be on Facebook.
Yep. That'll be on the Smiles at Sea Facebook page. They can watch for free. And enjoy live CE, which is, I think, pretty cool.
And with our listeners in 172 countries, it literally doesn't matter where they are. They'll have access to this completely free. Elijah, I'm going to put a link to your Facebook group in the show notes so that in case any of our members aren't members of your Facebook group, they can become members and be able to watch the Dentistry's Got Talent event that precedes the Cuba cruise.
Yeah, that would be great. The Facebook page, I'll give you the link for sure for that. It's pretty easy to Smiles at Sea. It's a Facebook page that they'll be able to check it out on.
Yeah. Hey, let's talk about Dental Hub 360 because you and your partners in that project are doing some incredible things. Tell us about Dental Hub 360.
Absolutely. Well, I'll start by saying that we have Dentistry's number one podcast app that you are on. The Thriving Dentist Show is actually on this podcast app. And essentially, you download it from your smartphone And you can check out, you know, all the podcasts and watch it straight from your phone, which is pretty cool, I think. And Dental Hub 360 is essentially, it was created from myself, Dr. Glenn Vo, Dr. Nessa Holmes, and Dr. Chris Hoffpower. And together, all of our groups combined are roughly 100,000 members within our groups. And we wanted to create a central hub, essentially for people to go and to collaborate. And so what we did is we brought to life Dental Hub 360, which we are calling the social network for dentistry. And on it is podcasts. It's hundreds of training videos, whether it's clinical or practice management. And we also have on there practice resources. So any kind of forms that you could ever imagine that you would need in a dental practice, you can go to practice resources and you can download them for free. You can watch all of our training videos for free. And also, you know, a lot of people have things on their in their dental practices that they don't use anymore. They have extra. So what we've done is we've created a marketplace that's kind of like eBay for dentistry, where, you know, dentists and dental team members can buy and sell in a safe zone on the marketplace. So we have an app and we also have a website. And, you know, speaking of that, Gary, you know, I know you do some training yourself with dental practices, and I think some of your trainings would be very valuable for us to feature on the app if you have anything recorded.
Count on it. In fact, I actually have a number of recording sessions coming up where I'll be recording very specific segments for Dental Hub 360.
Wow.
So really excited about using that platform to provide information to our profession in a more accessible, convenient format.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, I've said it before, but it bears repeating. I mean, we truly are living in amazing times, aren't we, Elijah?
We are. Wait until AI comes out.
You know, AI, artificial intelligence is, we're just beginning to see the very beginning of where this can go. You know, he's a mutual friend of both you and I, Peter Diamandis. I know you know Peter, and Peter's doing some very cool things with AI. And I get excited when I think about what might be right around the corner in terms of education and coursework that is going to fully leverage the engine that's available through artificial intelligence.
Yes, absolutely. I have some plans myself, but I don't know any technical things with AI. I might be a year late. I think I was about 6 months late with Facebook Live before that came out, before we brought in Dentistry's Got Talent. So probably we're going to wait till about 6 months after AI totally hits. And what I would like to do is bring AI to education, to where not only could you watch from your cell phone, but you could essentially watch from your glasses or your goggles that you put on, and that person will be standing right in front of you and educating. That is my ultimate vision with Dentistry's Got Talent. And you know what? I almost forgot about something really important, Gary. It means a lot to me. And I'd like to talk about it. Is that okay?
Please.
So my big vision with putting all of these hundreds of dental professionals on a ship was to one day fill a ship and then go and do something great with all of those dental professionals. What I mean by something great is do a mission. And so for the past couple of years, I've been attempting to do a mission at these ports that we go to, whether it's Cozumel or Bahamas or Cuba, wherever it is. And I've been having a really hard time getting in because of all of the, you know, the red tape, essentially. And so what we've decided to do is we've decided to give back and do a mission right here in our own country. So the March the 5th and March the 6th, before we get on the cruise ship, we have a 30-chair facility that we're going to be providing free dentistry to hundreds of patients that are in need. It's been something that I've wanted to do for the longest time, and to see it actually come to fruition and happen is such a blessing. You know, dentists, hygienists, assistants, even if they're not even going on the cruise, we're providing licensing, temporary licensing for this mission in Florida, for even people that are outside of Florida, to just give back and to help people for 2 days that really, you know, really, really deserve it. And I'll tell you, I've been on missions often, and I've been on a lot of missions overseas, and there's no better feeling than going and there's somebody who you don't even know, and you're taking them out of pain or you're helping them, and you come in your life, you change it, and then you leave, it's the best feeling ever. So that is something that I would love for anybody who's interested to come and help with as well.
You know, Elijah, I'll share a comment related to that. I've also been involved in many missionary projects like this. And I like to say that I'm never quite sure who benefits more, the patient that receives the care or the person that's providing it.
You're right.
I think the benefit benefits are mutual. Yes. How cool. I didn't know about that, but that is very cool. And I can imagine that you'll have an easier job with the logistics by doing that stateside before the trip on March 5th and 6th. And what a great way to deliver care and to help those in need. So hats off. Hey, I want to take a minute and surprise you for just a minute. We didn't talk about this in our pre-production discussion, but one of my experiences on the Alaska cruise was just how incredible your team is.
Oh, I know. Yes.
As a speaker, you know, Elijah, I have over 16,000 hours from the podium. Mm-hmm. I've had the privilege of speaking for 39 years in dentistry, and have had a chance to speak at almost every major dental meeting in the U.S. and Canada. And I have to tell you, as a speaker, I have never had such an amazing experience, literally from start to finish, with your team.
Wow.
It made it so easy for me just to focus on my message and my content. And I literally didn't have to worry about anything else. And the other thing about it is that courtesy and that customer service didn't just extend to the speakers, it extended to every one of the attendees as well.
Absolutely. I really appreciate that. And I'll be sending all of my team to hear this, this message. And I'll also say this, you know, the growth of Smiles at Sea wouldn't have happened if it weren't for my amazing team. You know, it's like this, whenever you're on that ship, you're in our house, right? You're on our house for the week or for the weekend, and you're our guests. And we want to make sure that everybody feels it. And that's the experience that they remember. And so thank you for acknowledging that. I'm sure they will be super happy. You know, they make it to where, you know, when I go on these ships, you know, I basically get to build relationships with people. I don't have to do the checking into class and the making sure in the day to day. My team does all that. So that way I can go around and I can actually talk to people and thank them for coming. And it's a really good situation that we've been in. You know, we now have grown significantly, and we're on track to, by the year 2023, to fill entire cruise ships, not just once a year, but twice a year.
Wow. Well, I wanted to bring that up because, as a dentist trying to learn how to better manage their team and how to be more effective with their team, you would be very wise to follow Elijah and watch what he does with his team, because you have created a spirit and a customer service perspective that is literally unmatched. As you come out and you attend that Cuba cruise, or you attend the you watch Dentistry's Got Talent on Facebook Live, watch what Elijah's doing and watch his leadership and watch his modeling of behavior that his team follows, because it's a great lesson in how to become a very effective, powerful leader on your own. So hats off, Elijah. You do a great job with that.
Hey, thank you for that, Gary. You just got me goosebumps thinking about my amazing team. Appreciate it.
They are incredible. Well, hey, I couldn't be more excited about this coming October. Cuba. I mean, how cool is that? Only a few years ago, we weren't able to go to Cuba. And now we can go. You know, how cool is that? So there's a Smiles at Sea Cuba cruise with literally a who's who of speakers in dentistry. There's the Dentistry's Got Talent proceeding the Smiles at Sea Cuba cruise. There's the mastermind. I love your subtitle, that the meeting for the future, you know, happening even before that. And there's just so many different ways to get involved. And of course, the great work that you're doing with Dental Hub 360 is also noteworthy, and truly bringing together diverse groups inside dentistry to advance the entire profession. So, hey, I want to take a minute and just say thanks for all the cool stuff you're doing.
Yes, yes. Thank you for being a part of it.
So I've got your website, smilesatsea.com. If our listeners want to reach out to you, what is there a best way for them to do that? Is that through social media? How would you prefer our listeners reach out to you?
Yeah, good question. So my number one channel is absolutely social media. You can message me even if we're not friends, Elijah Desmond. Another way to reach out to me, if you have any specific questions, you can email me at elijah@basicdentistry.com. And then if you have any questions about the cruise itself, if you want to know more details about the cruise, the best number to reach out to get information on that is 954-880-3968.
Let me repeat that for our listeners' benefit. I'll put it in the show notes. But the telephone number to reach out and get more information about Smiles at Sea would be 954-880-3968. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Awesome. Well, hey, I'm going to see you at a number of events between now and then, but I can't wait to see you in October. That is going to be a blast. These literally will be a who's who of speakers in dentistry with our best material and a great venue and a great group of attendees. So, Elijah, man, thanks for all that you do. I appreciate every bit of it.
Yes. Thank you, Gary. Appreciate it.
Hey, I want to take a minute and thank our listeners. We love what we do here at the Thriving Dentist Show. Couldn't do it without you. Three things you can do to support our work. You can tell a colleague about the podcast. There might be some dentists that you know that have never heard the word podcast. Hey, tell them about it and tell them about the Thriving Dentist Show. Secondly, you can write a review. You can jump on iTunes and write a review. A positive review on iTunes works very much like a positive review on Google works for your practice. Third thing you can do is you can hit the subscribe button. You can do that on iTunes. You can do that on Google Play. You can do that on whatever your podcast directory of choice is, including the Dental Hub 360 podcast app. Hit subscribe, and that means every time we upload a new show, you automatically receive that one and never miss a future show, and it'll be right there for your convenience. On that note, let me take a minute and simply say thank you and tell you I look forward to connecting with you on the next Thriving Dentist Show.
When you cry, be sure to dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide, and don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride, don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. When you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big.